Here are some of the emails that I receive on a daily basis.
Hey Bharat, I've studied my BTech mechanical from VTU and my score in bachelor's is 67.5%, and I wish to study a master's degree in mechanical engineering from a public university, tuition free and renowned. Now, I want you to understand that I come from a middle class family and thus enrolling in your course is a bit of a challenge for me. Thus, without a guaranteed seat in any of the public universities, preferably TUM, RWTH, or KIT, I wouldn't be able to commit so much money. Please let me know if that would be possible. Thanks and regards.
So, I mean, preferably TUM, RWTH, and KIT. That is also the preference for almost like, you know, 8, 10, 20,000 other students who apply to these programs and these universities every single year. And the 67.5% score, like I've said previously, like that just absolutely doesn't fit. So sometimes you can see that some of these emails are a bit unreasonable, but it is not their fault. Many of the students who write to me, their emails are pretty innocent. They have a good intention behind, they actually want that particular thing to happen. But just because of the information that they have been reading online on Quora, on other YouTube videos and so on, they just get a skewed perspective of how things are actually working in Germany. I've clarified it in many of my previous YouTube videos that I've made on this channel. And unlike many other YouTube channels where you would see that the majority of the focus is on entertainment, for me, it actually makes sense that I add value so that you're able to get from point A to point B in a much more precise way and you don't face a lot of troubles along the way. In scenarios like this, who is to blame? It's generally the study abroad consultants who have guaranteed admission posted all over their billboards.
Nice.
And many times these consultants would not reveal it or not disclose it, that they are going to actually force the student to study in one of the private universities. Now again, there's nothing wrong with private universities. I've said it multiple times before. There are some very good private universities, but there are definitely some bad private universities, and you need to watch out for that. But many of these people, they don't even have that incentive because for them, that's a one-time business. A student comes to them, they get them across, they get the money, and that's it. They don't need to worry about word of mouth or something because generally many of these consultancies are in smaller places and so on, and that is then not a big issue for them. But this can actually be very harmful for the student's finances, his mental health, because maybe he took a lot of loan for a program that he didn't need to take the loan for. In those kind of scenarios, it is just not a right fit. And many of these people, for example, these study abroad consultants, the number of students that they receive is very limited. That means they're not able to make a nice picture with what kind of data points they can expect admission in specific universities. On Big Academy, we have been collecting this data since 2016, and we have over 1,800 students enroll in the complete course for studying in Germany. So we have a much better idea of with what kind of data points, with what kind of bachelor score, with what kind of work experience, what kind of IELTS score and so on, and what kind of universities you can get an admission in. And we give exclusive access to this data to the students who are enrolled in the complete course for studying in Germany. And again, there is a legal clause that they are not allowed to share it with anybody else because it is the property of the Big Academy. So when you work with the help of data, of course, it is much easier and much more reliable to give some kind of specific direction or specific guidance. The thing with guaranteed admission is, again, most of these guaranteed admissions are generally done with one of the private universities that these consultants have, and they get a nice affiliate commission from that, which generally ranges from 10 to 15% of the entire tuition fee. So this can go anywhere from 1,500 to 2,500 euros for a particular program. Of course, the fee is also much higher for MBA programs and so on. And the point is not that you're earning money, like that is not the bad thing. Of course, everybody wants to earn money. You are going abroad not to study, you're going abroad because you can study and then earn money afterwards. I don't have a problem with that. The problem is when you give a biased advice which might not be in the best interest of the student you're guiding. And this is generally what I see over and over again. I mean, okay, if the profile just exactly fits a private university and the student is completely on board with it, yes, go ahead with that, but most of the people don't work that way. Now, how do you guarantee admission? You can guarantee admission by one, if you're either on the admission council of that particular university or that particular program, or two, you know that this university or this program, not a lot of students apply, and essentially anybody who applies gets an admit from that particular university or that particular program. Now, when you're thinking about coming to Germany, you know that most of the students want to study in free public universities, which means the competition is very high there. If you want to get a place there, there is no guarantee whatsoever. It could be easier to get inside public universities which have paid programs, because you also have, for example, in RWTH, a lot of MME programs, so Masters of Management and Engineering programs with different kind of subdomains afterwards. So in those kind of scenarios, yes, if they're charging 4,000-5,000 euros per semester, it is easier for you to get an admission there, because not many other students are applying to those kind of programs. And for university, it is also financially a beneficial thing. But for most of the free programs, of course, like, there is absolutely no guarantee whatsoever. The best thing you can do is, like I always say, first, apply early. Second, make sure your documents are 100% in order. And third, do not make any kind of mistake while filling out the application form when you're filing the documents and your application on the university's portal. These are a few very important things that you can do to improve your chances of getting an admission in a public university. But if you want to, be sure that you want to study in a specific semester, and you're like, okay, I just want to leave India, doesn't matter, like, you know, what kind of university is it? Again, there are some good private universities available, but there are also some very bad ones. So you have to really make the distinction. You have to get expert guidance in those kind of scenarios. And in those cases too, if you need any kind of help whatsoever, we can also help you with the complete course for studying in Germany, because we just have so much data behind it. So we can guide you in the best way possible. If you have any kind of questions whatsoever, write me an email at Bharat@bharatingermany.com and I'll get back to you there.